everybody. I'm back, and hopefully I'm back for good. I've been really busy lately with a whole bunch of different things, but as soon as school let out, I built a big old huge chicken coop in 4 days with my dad. I've been really proud of that, and we put 2 speckled Sussex in there and 2 Silkies. And as you can see, a lot of things have changed. My tomatoes are putting on really good. Some of them are starting to ripen up, and they're looking really good. My 2 guinea hens, they're long gone. They died on their nest full of eggs. I think a fox got them at night while we were on vacation. So I got 4 new guineas. 2 of them should be pied. One's a normal pearled, and the other one is a white one. So we'll see how that turns out. And there's just a whole bunch of things to show you. Well, I think my cucumbers, they got like a cucumber bug or something, but they've put on over 80 pounds of cucumbers, but they've had a good run. And there's a lot of things to show you, so let's get started. So a few of my potato plants have flowers, just a few, but overall they're looking really nice and healthy. These right here are the Yukon Golds. And these down here are the Red Pontiac. Now, this is the only problem I'm having with these potato bugs. And this is another bad spot with the potato bugs eating my plants. So I'm not sure what to do here, so if you have any recommendations, I'll surely accept them and try them out. I heard that putting straw around a tomato, around these plants will help out a little bit. But we'll see what happens. So I just dug the potatoes, and all these bushes up here in the front, you know, up until about here, that's where I've already hand dug them out. But it looks like a pretty good harvest of potatoes. I'm sure there's a whole bunch more in the dirt. But down here, this is the Red Pontiac potatoes. So I'll get to digging and sifting through all this dirt, and I'll show you later what the harvest is. So I got done sifting through all the dirt. I used a little rake, and I'm pretty sure I got like 99% of the potatoes. There might be a few stragglers, but so I'm gonna go through the tractor once more with the little plow attachment. I'm gonna make sure I got everything, and then I'm gonna sort the small little new potatoes out like these with the big ones like that. Hey there everybody, so this is the potato weigh-in, and so on the right here is the Yukon Gold, on the left is the Red Pontiac, and down here are the smaller potatoes, which I think are called new potatoes. Now what I noticed with my Yukon Gold was there's hardly any smaller potatoes. On average, I got bigger potatoes. I got some pretty big potatoes on average. On my Red Pontiac, I got a whole bunch of these small potatoes. And I also got some very big potatoes, like this one right here, if I can get it. That one's huge. But my family actually likes the Yukon Golds better. And actually, I've already harvested at least 10 pounds. I don't know, because I just gave them away to some friends and some neighbors. But we're going to do a weigh-in and just show you this scale works here. I have a 12-pound weight, and also have a 10-pound weight. So let's see how good this works. Right. 10 pounds. Gonna reset it. Try the 12-pounder. There you go. Reset it. Let's try them both. Oops. 22. So the scale works. And let's get counting. So let's start out with the red Pontiac. Forgot to reset it. £30.5. Now let's do the Yukon Gold. £24. And now for the little minis. You gotta reset it again. £9.5. Alright, so that brings us out to a total of £64. And remember, I only planted 16.5 pounds, 17, of somewhere in there, between 16.5 and 17 pounds. And I got 64 pounds. That's not even including the 10 pounds I already picked out. Which it's at minimum 10 pounds because it was a good bit. So this is my potato harvest. I think I got a really good ratio. And these are definitely some nice, really nice potatoes. Oh, and these little baskets they're in, they don't weigh much anything. Probably 0.1 or 0.2. They're really, really light. It's only 10 o'clock in the morning, and we're in the shade, and look how hot it is. Not even the June bugs are making noise. I mean, the cycads. I think that's what they're called. It is hot. So this right here is my yellow squash row. And you can see this is the first female flower I've had. So that's doing nicely. So next, over here, this is my gray zucchini squash. I think this might be a characteristic of the gray zucchini, because they have gray leaves, but bunches of flower, and actually, so they're going to be having stuff really soon. They're looking great. So here's the yellow squash. You can probably see how much they've grown. And I've gotten a good bit of squash from them. Like, this is about the good size to pick them. They're really good. And my zucchini over here. Oh yeah, I lost one squash because it looked like something trampled it, or the hose ran over it or something. But zucchinis over here are doing pretty awesome. They're getting huge. And they make the most beautiful zucchini squashes you'll see. I've gotten a bunch of these guys. But actually, it's better to pick them when they're larger. Like I think it said, 6 to 8 inches long. They're actually better when they're a little bigger. They're really beautiful. Along with the leaves, I think later on in the day, when it gets hotter and hotter, this little whiteness in their leaves comes out more. But these guys are really heat tolerant. I like it. I'm definitely going to replant this gray zucchini next year. So this right here is my
cantaloupe and watermelon row, and they're doing great. And my cucumbers. Now my dad is insistent on telling me that I don't need to trellis these cucumbers, but he don't believe me that that's what they need. But these guys are just loaded with flowers, loaded with them. And I'll see if I can try and find a cucumber for y'all. Here we go. I found a couple of developing cucumbers. And there's another right here. But they're getting along. This is my biggest one right here. While I'm over here next to the cantaloupe and watermelon row, I want to show you my lemon squash. I originally had 3 plants, but I had ants. When they're little, the ants would eat them. But, so this will be the second little squash I've had. It looked just like a lemon. And if you notice, the stem, if you can see that or not, but the stem actually turns yellow a little bit, and then it goes green. This is a really cool squash. I'm definitely going to grow more of that next year, too. So this right here is a cantaloupe. I don't see any cantaloupes on it. Here's the huge watermelon. It's got bunches of flowers. And I believe there's some pretty big watermelons on it. So this is the biggest plant I have so far. Cantaloupe, watermelon. Oh, and I also have some little squash plants that came up on their own. Now, this cantaloupe, there's already a couple on there, like this big one, and this one. But they're all doing really good. And here's another watermelon. My squash, it was doing awesome. I think I got over 80 pounds of cucumbers. I'm gonna say cucumbers. But I think they got a cucumber bug problem or something's not right, because I think they should be constantly producing. Like, they're not even growing a full size, and then they're doing like this now. It's just weird. So I definitely got something wrong with those. But they had a good run. You know, I got over 80 pounds from them. So they did really good. Here's my bell peppers. This is the California Wonder and the Sweet Rainbow Mix. So if you noticed, I've strung these guys. They're getting too tall and they were falling over trying to hold up those bell peppers. But they're looking nice and stocky and thick. And over here, I have bunches of bell peppers. And this one's turned black for some reason. The place I got it from, they must have had bad seed or something, but it's not rotten, it's just a black bell pepper. So these are my bell peppers. Up front, like I said in the last video, that's California Wonder, And back here, the sweet rainbow. Now actually, this pepper turned black because it's a sweet rainbow mix. So I just didn't get much of a mix. I got like all green and one black. But it's really pretty. But I've picked these guys three times really hard. Got three big productions, but I'm getting ready to have a fourth here, if you can see all those. They're just loaded down with them. Loaded down. Black one's kind of harder to see in a camera. That's a big one right there. Let's see. There. I've already picked that one clean. So yeah, I've gotten a really good production of bell peppers. And I think next year, I'm going to double the amount that I have. Maybe triple. I don't know, I'm still thinking about it. Because I definitely want to really sell some stuff. Like, this year I've reached a limit, of bell peppers and squash and zucchini. And tomatoes. So if I want to sell some stuff, I'm going to have to grow a lot bigger. So here's the Brandywine tomatoes. They're doing good so far. They also have flowers on them. And my Park's Whoppers tomatoes, these right in here I bought, and every single one that I bought has a tomato on it. And this one right here has a little cluster. But this is the reason why I'm going to end up stringing all my tomatoes, because you can see they're all falling over. And these right here are doing nice and thick, good. I ended up just letting this tomato plant V and have two little growth heads. So I'm pruning all of my tomatoes. I did the same thing here and just let it V out. And right here, this is my sweet banana peppers. I did the same thing with these as my bell peppers and strung these guys. I don't really know when to pick them. I guess this would be a good size to pick these guys. And some of them are turning black. That's not right. It's just a natural color or something. So I've been working really hard on the tomatoes up there in the big main patch, keeping them really good. And I just hadn't had the time to dig a nearly 2 foot deep hole and stuff. So they're still laying on the ground and they're doing pretty good. You can see I think these are the pink Brandywines. They're doing pretty good, but they all have nice tomatoes on them. So far, I'm not really having any problems with them. They seem pretty good. And my Park's Whopper down here. I'm getting ready. I'm in the process of digging the hole. I only have one hole dug so far, and it's not quite deep enough yet. But these things have got bunches of tomatoes on them, and a few are starting to ripen up, like that one right there, that one, and these two down here. Oh, and this one right here. But yeah, so I really need to get to working to make them look like tomatoes up there that are all strung up and everything. And I actually had a watermelon vine pop up from nowhere. I think it's from last year's watermelon, but I didn't grow watermelon anywhere near here. So I think it might have been a seed that dropped out of my pockets or something. But we'll see how that turns out. It should be the same variety of watermelon that's up there. And everything looks good. These peppers are doing really good. We've been getting bunches and bunches of these guys. So I'm already picking green beans, bell peppers, sweet banana peppers, yellow squash, cucumbers are starting to need to be picked, and I think that's it. So let's head down to the corn patch. Now I'm letting my beans go to seed because they're heirloom. I really like them. Probably the only part I didn't like was their bush. And I think the pole beans will keep on producing on and on and on. These, they just put a huge yield out, and then that's it. See, like on these older plants, there's nothing on them. But on some of the younger plants, I learned, and so I left some. But I definitely want to grow more of this variety. Or I might choose a different variety, but I really like these. And I'll show you my pea seed I collected too. Now this is how many pea seeds I have. Down there on the very bottom, that's actually some paper to keep all the moisture and water out if any gets in there. But I had a little bit of time on my hands and I counted them all. And I actually have enough to plant 74 feet. And I was aiming for 2 55-foot rows this year. So I don't think that's going to happen. So I'm not going to have any seeds to give away for these. But I really like this variety of pea. I didn't think there was anything wrong with it. It did really good. So the corn row is doing pretty good. I definitely have some nice stocky plants. But I was just looking, and the reason why they're shorter and not like 10 feet tall was the fact that they're so widely spaced. If they're spaced like right up against each other, then they'd be, you know, taller. But here's the corn already starting to come out. But I think I counted 80 plants. And my okra patch down here. I think I planted an okra just maybe a little bit too late this year. Because they're still little babies. But I've been busy lately. So I just did with what I can. But it looks like they're all putting on their first leaf now. Some of them their second leaf. And even further down here, this open spot right here, I'm going to be planting pumpkins. Now last year, I had pumpkins in July, I think. So I don't want July pumpkins again. So I think if I plant them now, they're going to be about ready. Maybe a little later than October. So I'm aiming for October. And finally, last but not least, This is the main tomato patch. Now probably the first thing you'll notice I did was I used straw mulching, and I've strung them using a Florida weave method. And I made these stakes. What we did, we bought 2x4s, and then we got my grandpa's table saw and we stripped them down the middle. So now they're 2x2s, and they're working pretty good. But as you can see, I got bunches and bunches of tomatoes. But overall, they're doing pretty good. It's just been so hot. Right now it's 100 degrees. And this whole week it's been above 100 degrees. But all the tomatoes are looking really nice. Oh, and you might notice, going down the middle, I think every 4 plants, I have 1 marigold in between them. But I put the straw mulch down to help keep in the water, because during the day it just evaporates right away, and cool the soil a little bit, maybe just a degree or two, and just keep maybe some of the weeds up. There's another marigold that's flowering. And now we're back up at the front. And it looks pretty good from here. I think what I'm going to do is plant the rest of the bean seeds and the squash and the zucchini.